I hope you will see my actions as they are. Candid, plain, truthful. I hope I am able to put away this pain. Pain in which I know I'm not alone. Pain for which there is no description.
In a weird way, I think the prison bit is the least of her worries. You know, Emma is a recovering drug addict, mm-hmm. and you know, all of her actions are through that filter. And when all that structure that she's set for herself has been taken away from her through no real bad doing of her own. So it's a real shame. She was trying to rebuild her relationship with her father, and she thought she was, and then he betrayed her. I think that emotional place that she's in is far more overwhelming and far worse than actually being in the physical space of prison.
Now we have a new showrunner this
yeah, she's
this
great.
Season.
Yeah.
Can you tell us how she's sort of affecting the dynamic of the show?
I adore Farhad as well, the creator who was also the showrunner before. And I adore Dee. And you know, they're kind of similar in the sense that they're very calm and they're very intelligent and they have a real vision of how they want the show to be, and everybody loves both of them. So it wasn't a huge change in terms of like the type of personality that mm-hmm. came on board. So it's been really nice.
Hold up. I wanted to show you later when it healed, but
you'll see their relationship continue in some capacity, but I'm not sure how much romance is left.
Different, yeah. A different relationship. Did you interact with T.I. at all on set?
I haven't even met him.
No?
No.
No scenes together?
No.
Wow.
I love the way he talks, though. He talks like in this really, like, very kind of musical way.
Yeah. Have you seen any of his stuff on
a
the
bit
show?
Of stuff, and I love it because everything he says stays in your head because he's got this amazing way of speaking.
Yeah.
Yeah.